G'day. Dookie. It's been a while, but lots have happened since last time I posted a video. I sold my property, 5 acres, and girlfriend sold her house, and we bought a house together. And at the moment, we're living in town, in Traralgon, and it's not too bad. But there's been a lot of things going on the last couple of years. We've built a lot of things, Rita and I, and I was just going to show a few of the things we've built. So, see how we go. Okay, first thing we built when we got here was the aviary. We did a garden shed, 3 metres by 3 metres, and the birds were in there for a little while, had a window cut in the side. And decided we needed to have a bit of a flight for them. As you can see, they can fly. That's Sparky. Been Sparky for about 4 years. That's what we built originally, the aviary in Rosedale on the 5 acres. There's Goose. That's Birdie, that's his mum. That's Goose, and that's Sparky the dad. Bought a little girl over there, we called her Gander. Goose and Gander, the sexual orientation is back to front, but that's okay. We've got some meat pigeons, 3 of them at the moment. Haven't got names, it's sort of Hudson down there. But, don't have a male at the moment, we end up with a bit of interbreeding, so we culled all the males, put them in the freezer, and at the moment just got 3 females. Down there's Japanese quail. I eat the eggs off that one sometimes when she lays a couple. We need to get a couple more. I think we lost 3 of them in the move and 2 since then. And, they'd be mainly for eggs if we get any more. If they're babies, maybe we'd stick a few of them in the freezer. That's the nesting boxes. Here's where we keep the food. It's mouse proof. Nice. If you always do, we have an aviary. Nesting box there, another one around the corner, and the cage up there is to put the cockatiel feed in, otherwise it's pigeon steel. A couple of big containers of water there, and that's pretty much the aviary for now.